Hey everybody, we are now live and we're going to talk, Sarah and me, Brenda and Kara, all about SoPro Convention. Kara is going to ask us some questions, but if you have questions, feel free to type them into the chat window or on the side of the Q&A, and we will be happy to answer those questions for you. So, take it away, Kara.
All right. So first of all, Sarah, can you just give us a basic info about what is SoPro?
Okay, SoPro is a lecture-style convention in Chicago. It's going to be this September, the 15th through the 17th, and the goal of the convention is to teach people that either our song is a hobby or maybe they've already kind of dipped their toes in, maybe they have some patterns that they've already written, maybe they've contributed projects to magazines, but they want to go forward with their career in the sewing industry. So the classes at SoPro are going to help them do that because we have some amazing teachers that have already gone down this path before, and they're going to give you the specific information you need to move forward.
Great. And Brenda, can you walk us through what the weekend will look like as far as classes and layout?
Yeah, absolutely. So I've been to a lot of conventions before for different things, so this is going to be typical to that convention style. We're having it at a really nice hotel. It's the Hyatt Regency Hotel. It's near the O'Hare Airport in Chicago, which is nice because there's a free shuttle for anybody flying into O'Hare. And the first night, Thursday night, we're going to have a little get-together, so you can register throughout the day. We'll have a registration table open. And then there'll be a little cash bar and appetizers where we want people to be able to mingle, give their elevator pitch, and meet the other attendees at the event. And then Friday, we have classes all day. There's you can go to 5 classes on each day, and the same on Saturday. And then after classes, Sarah and I will let you know places that we're hanging out. There's a lot of really great restaurants and activities nearby, so you can continue to create those contacts that you've met throughout the day.
Now, Sarah, what about someone who may be interested in multiple things? You mentioned fabric designers and pattern designers. What if someone wants to do both? Are we going to be set in the classes that we take, or how will that work?
Yeah, that's a really good question, and I've had that same question from other people that have registered as well. While there are the different tracks, fabric designer, pattern designer, author, and blogger, while we do have those tracks, you're welcome to take classes in a different track. Say most of the classes that you are interested in are in the pattern designer track, but there's something in the fabric designer track, maybe a branding class that you'd like to take as well, you're welcome to switch back and forth between the tracks, and you set your schedule, which is really nice because you make it what you want it to be, and that's how your weekend will go.
Great. And Brenda, you mentioned some of the teachers. I see you have some really great keynote speakers, so can you tell me about why you chose them?
We chose Tula Pink and Pat Sloan to be our keynote speakers for our first event. Both of these women truly embody the whole spirit of the industry, in my opinion. Pat Sloan, for example, she is super excited and energetic and very great when it comes to teaching people about classes and things like that. She teaches a lot. She goes almost every weekend to teach an event. Not only that, but she has a fabric line with Moda. She's written 30 books. I mean, 30 books is an impressive number. I mean, I can't even imagine. So these are people that are truly doing the things that they're going to teach you about. Tula, for example, this year, her new Slow and Steady fabric collection will be her 20th fabric collection. She's in her 30s, and she's had 20 fabric lines. Like, that is unheard of in the industry for a lot of people, and she's succeeding at that. And she also is teaching at really big events. SoPro, she's teaching at Sisters. She's taught on a cruise recently. So she's out there getting to know her audience as well as succeeding as a fabric designer.
That's excellent. That sounds really exciting. So, Sarah, what kind of things should I bring along if I'm planning to attend to make sure I can make the most of the weekend?
So this is a lecture-style conference. We won't be doing any sewing, so you want to make sure you bring your notebook and paper to take tons of notes, because I know everyone will be busy writing during all of their classes. Definitely want to bring some business cards if you don't already have some. Moo or Vistaprint are both great places to have some business cards made, and you want to have all of your important information on there. Email address for sure is the number one. Name, if you have a website already, you want to have that information on there. Telephone number as well. And some of the attendees are planning on bringing buttons to trade. A button could have something as simple as your logo, a sewing saying, and so those are the buttons and the business cards are great networking tools that you can bring with.
Great. And Brenda, you mentioned having an elevator pitch. Can you tell us a tiny bit more about that and maybe some of the people that we would need to be prepared to speak to?
Yeah. I think besides just the people who are teaching, we have some really great people that are coming to teach classes. Like, for example, Mickey Kruger, he is the president of Wyndham Fabrics. So if you are looking to have a fabric collection, he's pretty much the person to pitch to. I think if you are a pattern designer, for example, bring a few examples of your pattern. You may find other people in the industry, not just the people that are teaching, but also your fellow attendees who can give you tips. Maybe they have a pattern that's published and they can look over yours and tell you what they think. Or maybe they're a blogger and they like your pattern and they want to make it and help promote it on their blog. I think that is very important. And an elevator pitch is basically telling someone about yourself and your business in the time that it would take you to go in an elevator with someone. So about 30 seconds about yourself. Like, my name's Brenda. I have a blog. It's called Just Fit Frayed. I have a pattern design company. I design fabric for RJR Fabrics. I own a fabric company called Pink Castle Fabrics. And we run events called Glam Stitch A Lot and also SoPro. And then you can, with the elevator pitches, so like if someone was talking to me and they're like, oh, you know, I'd really like to buy fabric. Where's your fabric store located? And that kind of leads into more conversation. But you want to have just a 30-second, like, I'm here for SoPro because I'm really excited about blank. What are you excited about? Where are you from? And then that helps to start that conversation with other people.
Mm-hmm. Now, Sarah, what kind of other resources are available for people in the craft industry that want to make money and may want to connect with other people? What could we tell them to look into or in the future, maybe after SoPro's over, where can we direct people to keep the conversation going?
Okay, so besides SoPro, which is, you know, just this one-time event, we'll have another event after that, but on a daily basis, there's a website called Craft Industry Alliance, and one of our speakers, Kristen Link, is the co-founder. She co-founded this organization with Abby Glassenberg, and the goal of their organization is similar to SoPro in that they want to help crafters, so not just people that sew, knitters, other creative businesses. They want to give those businesses the resources to move forward. So for example, email addresses for magazines if you want to submit projects to magazines. They have bulletin boards, which are great because if somebody has a question, other people can jump on and contribute and help them kind of navigate and find an answer for their business. So it's another great support system besides SoPro, and it's called Craft Industry Alliance, and the website is craftindustryalliance.org.
Great, thank you. So as we start to kind of wrap up this little taste of SoPro, Brenda, is there anything else that you'd like to add or tell us about to get us excited about the weekend?
First of all, it's just going to be a lot of fun. People in the sewing industry are great people in general. We have a Facebook group that you can find if you look up SoPro, and already the people in the Facebook group are talking about meeting up and making friends and things like that. And I think that to get the most out of the event, just get yourself out there and talk. If you're interested in something, there's going to be somebody there that's going to help you. And I think bringing some ideas to the table, you're going to meet people and they're going to give you new ideas too. So make sure that you're following up with those people after the event as well. If you meet other bloggers and you decide, oh, we could work together on a blog tour, like a summer sampler or something like that, you know, make sure to follow up with those people. This is the best time to make friends that are just like you, trying to make it out there in the industry. Use those people and not just the people, like, you know, everybody wants to be best friends with Tula Pink because she's great, and she is great, but then you're also going to have, you know, 100 other people that are just like you. That's very valuable.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sarah, what about you?
I just encourage me as an introvert, it's hard for me to talk a lot of times, especially in groups, but when I get going on something sewing related, it's much easier for me to put myself out there, and I, you know, people of different personalities are going to be coming to the event, and just take a chance. If it makes you feel uncomfortable, do it anyway, because I know everybody that's purchased tickets already really wants to move forward with their careers in the sewing industry, and if you want it, you know, maybe be a little uncomfortable sometimes, but just go for it. So,
great. Yeah, thank you, ladies, so much for sharing some of the information and helping us with that. I would say that if anyone watching has any other questions, a great place to start would be our website at soproconvention.com, and that from there you can find email addresses and contact forms. Tickets are available, room blocks, all of that can be found there, and please let us know if you have any other questions. So thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.